Cool that you guys are still working together. I mean, how does that feel to have Coach, you know, Coach Khabiib with Coach Javier? The student becomes the coach with you.
Well, he's becoming the coach with me, and he's going to be the bigger coach at one point or another, because he has more love and more passion to watch the guys and make sure they're doing things than I do. I mean, I'm kind of the burning light that's burning bright, but it's dimming. He's burning brighter than ever, and he's such an unbelievable coach that, you know, I wouldn't doubt soon people call him the greatest coach of all time too. Becoming the GOAT to the greatest coach of all time, I can 100% see Khabib being that person, because, you know, his love for his guys, his love for training, and, you know, still to this day, you know, Khabib, you know, people may not realize that, but Khabib right now, still, if you ask me, can Khabib beat who and who right now, I said he can beat them all right now, still. Khabib just, you know, just get ready to go. I said, hey, if he wanted to fight next week, he can fight next week. I mean, he's in shape all the time. That's something that I get privileged to see. And the only thing that's different about Khabib now than before is before, no one can win a round except Islam here and there. Now he lets the guys win a lot. He lets them, when he spars with them, he lets them win so they can get better. But before, when he was fighting, you are not getting it. You're getting your ass whooped, or you're getting handled properly. You know, not whooped on, but you definitely know you were being handled. The only challenge, the super challenge, was always Islam. Islam was always a super challenge for Khabib. But to this day right now, like I said, he could still reign over everybody if that's what he wanted to do. But I seriously doubt he would ever decide to do anything other than what he's doing now. He loves coaching. He loves promoting Eagle Fighting Championships. He's going all over the world with it. He just went to Kyrgyzstan, I believe, or one of the Stan countries, and he had over 10,000 people come watch. He had he met the prime minister of that country, and you know, hey man, he's on the rise, huge. You know, Eagles Fighting Championship is becoming a very prominent you know, European league, and even the Middle East promotion. You know, fantastic, and I don't see him changing what he's doing. I don't see him deciding that, oh, I'm on a big money fight or anything like that. I just see him continuing doing what he's doing, being involved in business ventures that he gets offered all the time. I mean, his brand is gold. So anybody gets attached to him, it's a great thing. Look at us, you know, our podcast yep, is doing fantastic.
Thank you, Khabib.
As a podcast, because of Khabib, straight up. You know, Right. Straight up, we get a lot of fans coming on board because I'm his coach and I'm still active with him, and people want to hear inside scoop on Khabib and all the fighters, because no one else as a coach has that, and I do. So, and I realize that, and I realize that the fans are coming to hear things about who's the next guy from Eagles MMA. I mean.